heel voor een Palestinian state. En de borders of 67, de Jordan Valley, de Golan Heights. You know, that East Jerusalem, that they have to give it up, you know, to the Palestinians. And yeah, it's going to be a big problem because Israel will not be able to defend itself if they give away, for instance, the Jordan Valley. Like what you see happening now, they call it the Arab Spring, but it might turn into the Arab Winter. And you know, I'm speaking of as a person with a Palestinian background, and I see that everything is going wrong right now. You see even the Jordanians calling the Jordanian Palestinians to for the annulment of the peace agreement with Israel. And so who will give Israel the guarantee that if they give away these parts of land, that they will have peace? I mean, they're trying to infiltrate Israel from Syria, from Lebanon, from many places. And so nobody can guarantee Israel peace. And so, yeah, as you said, like with these checkpoints, it's if there are no Palestinian terrorists, there are no checkpoints. You know, this is one of the problems. If there are no Palestinian suicide bombers, there is no wall. Israel doesn't need to build a wall. And the thing is, they always put the blame on Israel.
Her står vi like ved Jordan, land faktisk. Og hvis du ser over grensen her sånn, så det veldig nær. Og det rart å tenke på at dette her skal da bli i gåsøgne den nye palestinske staten. Det skal det altså ikke bli. Og jeg sa det akkurat at Jordan har mer enn nok med å håndtere alt det landet de har. For der det så mye øde områder og så mye udyrket og fattigslige greier at ikke skjønner jeg hva de skal med dette her, men det har jo ingenting med sunn fornuft å gjøre. Og like ved her så går den gamle kontrollgaten, grensegaten, det for så vidt i bruk enda, for israelerne de pleier å patrullere her for å passe på at ingen terrorister kommer over, men det jo veldig lenge siden det har vært terrorister fra Jordan og over grensene her. Så har vi altså ørkenen, nei ikke ørkenen, men vi har fjellene på den andre siden. Og det, jeg tenker hele tiden på at alt dette her slik som det var på Jesu tid. Ingenting forandret. Og så har vi da denne krangelen gående om Jordandalen rett ved siden av oss. Og som dere ser så veien, dette hovedveien til nordover. Og den veldig trafikert hele tiden, så det både godstrafikk og persontrafikk og turisttrafikk oppover her. Så når du kommer til Israel neste gang, så får du sikkert en tur til oppover Jordandalen til Galilea. Og det veldig spennende å se.
Well, I brought something to explain to the Norwegian people the size of Israel. Imagine, you know, in Norway, it's a beautiful country. They have the mountains to ski, the fjords to fish, you know. They sit in their comfortable chairs in one of their two houses. They watch the news, which brings the misleading information about Israel, and they judge Israel. But as a Norwegian a nation, I want you to step into the shoes of the Israeli people for one moment. Imagine that you are Israel. Israel is surrounded by so many Arab nations, you can hardly see Israel on this map. But if you place Israel into Norway for a moment, Israel is smaller than the size of the county called Oppland. It's so small, and then you must imagine that maybe 5 million Norwegian people, all of them live in that small county. And then you must include 1 million Muslims inside that state. And then you must realize that all of Europe, it's all Muslim. You have 6 million Jewish people surrounded by 300 million Arabs. The size that the Arabs have, the size of the land, it's 650 times the size of the state of Israel. And then you have the whole world judging Israel. Can you imagine how Israel must feel? They are trapped. They live in a neighborhood all alone. Sometimes there's a terror attack or in Europe, or there something happens, you know, and people are like shaking, okay, a Muslim did a terror attack or something. But Israel is surrounded by so many people who want to destroy them. And, you know, in the official charter of the Hamas, which also, the Norwegian government, they support Fatah and also Hamas. Hamas is a terrorist organization, you know. They, in their official charter, they call for the destruction of the nation of Israel. They teach children to become suicide bombers, that the highest goal in life is to blow themselves up. And I cannot understand how can a government support that? And so I really hope that the eyes of the Norwegian people, yeah, it will open up. And because it's Israel is all alone, and Israel needs us. Israel needs support. Israel needs Europe. Would the United States give a part of Manhattan and Brooklyn to Al-Qaeda? Never. And just as Prime Minister Netanyahu said in his speech to the Congress in Washington, that Hamas is a Palestinian version of Al-Qaeda. And also the Fatah, they also promote children to die as a suicide bomber, as the highest, the most beautiful thing in life. Recently, yesterday, I saw a film of President Abbas, how he was applauding after a girl was singing, a young girl, she was singing that she wants to die as a martyr for Jerusalem. And this is the president that Israel has to negotiate with? Well, the thing is, there are some differences between Hamas and Fatah. And the most important difference is that Hamas is more honest. Fatah tries to destroy Israel through the peace process. This is the policy of Yasser Arafat. Land for peace. Of course we want land for peace. But every time they receive a piece of land, what happens? They fire rockets at Israel exactly from that piece of land. And so they do it in a sneaky way. Hamas is more honest. They're straight. We just want to destroy Israel, and we will use our women and children as human shields and as suicide bombers to achieve our goals. So it's very clear. And I was thinking, you know, the Norwegian government is blind. They don't know the facts. They don't know what's truly going on. But I cannot imagine that they don't know what's going on. This is what's going on, and there's just one thing. They need to repent, and I'm happy there's Vision Norge to tell them, you know, exactly what's happening there in Israel. Nobody wants to be oppressed by a dictator in any Arab country. And but the problem is, what is democracy? What if, you know, Mubarak, he left? What if the Muslim Brotherhood takes over? Will it become better? Or will it become worse for the Egyptian people and for the peace process? So you see all the same thing happening, you know, in Syria and all the other states, in Tunis. So who says it's an Arab Spring, you know? And there's only one nation that has to pay the price again for the Middle East Spring, and that's Israel. And but the thing is, you know, 6 million Jewish people were murdered in the Holocaust, you know, in Nazi Germany. And there's only one thing. This will never happen again, with or without the support of Norway. And Israel needs the support of Norway and when they're going to vote at the United Nations. But never a Holocaust again. And but there's a passion in my heart, you know, when God changed my life 6.5 years ago with one touch. He just filled my heart with love for the Jewish people. And we know Jews and Palestinians, they are enemies, but he filled my heart with so much love for them. And, you know, and when I meet them, I only want to hug them and love them and tell them, you know, as an Arab, that this is their land, that Jerusalem is their capital. They should not give away one inch of land. And, you know, and I noticed that encourages them. And And it's just amazing. It's a privilege to be with the Jewish people. And I think they are the most wonderful, the most special people on earth, you know. And it's when you only look at the part what they achieved as this, there are about 15 million Jewish people, what they achieved in the world, in science, in every aspect of life. And then you hear that also in Norway they want to boycott Israeli products. But if you take the Jewishness away, out of the world, I tell you, you got nothing left. You know, if for instance, if Norway wants to boycott Israeli products, well, they are not allowed to use computers, not allowed to use their mobile phones. If you have breast cancer, you cannot go to the hospital to take a breast scan. If you have heart problems, you cannot take medications. You cannot use Google. You cannot use Facebook. You cannot do anything. Your life will become a misery if you take the Jewishness out of the world. And it's just amazing, you know, to see what they achieve, this small nation. It's just, they're just a blessing to the world.